Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury. And, you know, the big question of the day is, why do they not want to take the Anthony Joshua fight? Because they have so many reasons to want to take the fight. Let's just start exploring those reasons to want to take the fight. The first reason is the fact that they would be a unified heavyweight champion. You know, you'd be unified with multiple belts if you're Tyson Fury. And if you're Deontay Wilder and you win, you can actually become undisputed, be in the record books. You'll be an automatic Hall of Famer. So you'd be, you know, if you're either guy, you'd have great credentials and resume to be a certified Hall of Famer at that point. No questions, no doubts. And you'd be considered the best in the world by beating what is considered the best heavyweight in the world. So at that point, why wouldn't you still want to fight? In addition to that, you'd also get the biggest payday of your career against Anthony Joshua. There will be no payday bigger than Anthony Joshua. He's the biggest star in boxing at this point, him and Canelo Alvarez. So if this guy's the biggest star in boxing, you're going to get the biggest payday. You're going to be able to get all the belts, and you could become a certified Hall of Famer. What is not to like or want to take about that fight? Because if you notice, other guys took the fight. If you notice, you know, Dominic Brazil took the fight. You look at Dillian White took the fight the first time. Multiple guys took the fight. You know, Vladimir Klitschko, who's a bigger name arguably than Wilder and Fury, especially when they fought, he took the fight at a 50-50. But that's because he was dominating the heavyweight division, and he brought thousands of people to the arena as well. He was a huge, massive name. So if you look at Wilder and Fury, yeah, these guys are big enough names, but at the same time, they're not on the level of Anthony Joshua. They don't fight the level of competition clearly as Anthony Joshua. Anthony Joshua fights top 10 ranked opponents every single time out. So the big question remains to be seen is, why don't these guys really want to fight? You know, it's easy to say ducking, but there has to be something more as to why these guys don't want to fight. Now, one thing is, Tony Bellew has recently done an interview, and I thought it was really, really weird. And the reason why he did the interview is he said a couple things that were really unbelievable is, and so let's just break down what he said in the interview, and we'll see if that's why these guys really don't want to fight Anthony Joshua. This is a direct quote from Tony Bellew, and it starts as, Joshua is offering some of these guys more in one night than they've earned in their whole career, and yet they still want to complain. He's also saying if they win and they rematch, he'll flip the terms. We know who the number one is. If you believe you can beat him, take the payday, and you'll make even more in the rematch. But do they really believe they can beat him, though? No, I'm not so sure. And I think that's the real ultimate key here, is that they really don't believe they can beat Anthony Joshua. There's a reason why Tyson Fury is coming off a long layoff would fight Deontay Wilder but not Anthony Joshua. There's a reason why Tyson Fury would face someone like a Tom Schwartz instead of facing top 10 ranked opponents every time out like Anthony Joshua. Imagine if Anthony Joshua would take this same approach and fight other guys like Tom Schwartz. He'd be crucified in the media. Even if you look at it at this point, Anthony Joshua is offering these guys 60-40. So he's taking 60, they're taking 40. He's offering them guaranteed money. Deontay Wilder's getting offered a guaranteed $100 million contract from DAZN. The fact that Anthony Joshua is doing so much, and you're not getting these terms for any other opponent, you're not getting the opportunity for stardom, fame, and history off of any other opponent than Anthony Joshua, why wouldn't you take it? And if Anthony Joshua was fighting Tom Schwartz, would he be getting respected? If Anthony Joshua was rematching Dominic Brazil, would he get any respect? You have to understand that Anthony Joshua's levels above what these guys have accomplished at this point, and these guys don't want to fight him because they see the level of competition he fights night in and night out every time he comes to the ring. He's not fighting easy pick'em fights. He's not fighting guys that he can just run through every time. He makes it look easy because he's a special talent. It's easy to sit back and criticize and say he's robotic or he's this, he's that. But when he's fighting the level of competition he is, they're not going to be easy fights. But he makes them look easy. He dispatches guys, and people hold him to a higher standard than they do Wilder and Fury. You have to look at it. Wilder and Fury must step up the level of competition. No one wants to see Fury versus Schwartz, and no one wants to see Wilder versus Brazil. They want to see these guys in tough competitive fights, and these guys aren't taking those fights. Only Anthony Joshua is. We understand who the number one heavyweight in the world is. It's simply Anthony Joshua, and we also understand why these guys truly don't want the fights. It's not the belts, it's not the money, it's because they truly don't believe they can win. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.